Hi, this is Dr. Claire, and today we're going to be talking about plant growth. So how plants actually grow. And plant growth is really quite different from something, say, like animal growth. So if you look at a plant, one of the things that they have that's different from a lot of animals is that they have cell walls. And so the cell walls prevent cells from really moving once they've grown or once they've divided. And so what that means is that they have plants have very specific areas where things are happening. So there are specific areas where cells are dividing. Those tend to be near root or shoot tips. And then you have areas where cells are growing, getting bigger. And then you have areas where they differentiate into the different tissue types within the plant. All right. So we're going to look at shoots and we're going to look at roots, and you'll see how they're a little bit different from each other. All right. So let's start with the shoot. So the shoot is the above ground part of the plant. Shoot elongation is dependent upon what's called the apical meristem, or the tip bud of that shoot. All right, so that's the place where cell division is going to be taking place. Okay, so you've got that zone of cell division right at the tip of the apical meristem, and then you have your leaves that branch off to the sides. What you see when you look at a shoot is that you tend to have these repeating segments called phytomeres. And those phytomeres consist of a node. At the node, you tend to have an axillary bud, a bud that goes off the side, as well as a leaf. And then you have an internode length before you come to another axillary bud with a leaf. And so you have that repeating structure. And then at the very tip of the shoot, you have that apical meristem. Okay? So all of that growth within that shoot is going to be happening in that apical meristem. The internode zones between those axial nodes are the parts where elongation will be happening. So cell division is happening up at the apical meristem, then you have that internode length, and so when that internode initially forms, it's going to be a particular length, and then those cells within that internode will elongate and allow the plant to grow a little bit taller, but there's no actual additional cell division going on during that elongation period. So you can see that the distance between the nodes might change a little bit, but that's caused by elongating cells, not by more cell division that's happening within those areas. All right. The axillary buds can provide a place for branches to form. So axillary buds are the source of leaves and also the source of new branches that are going to go off to the sides of the plant. Okay, so you've got your apical meristem at the top, you've got your axillary buds, and cell division can happen within the axillary buds, although sometimes they're relatively dormant. In terms of the structure of those axillary buds, there's a couple of different structures that you tend to see. Sometimes you have an alternate structure where you have an axillary bud on one side and then an internode length and then an axillary bud on the other side and then an internode length and then the other side again. So that's alternating. You can have opposite, where at each node you have an axillary bud on both sides, opposite of each other. Or you can have a whorled structure where at each node you have a number of different leaves coming off from the central stem. Okay. The apical meristem actually suppresses the growth of other buds lower down in the stem. So mostly the growth is going to be happening just from that apical meristem. If you cut off the apical meristem, however, the axial buds will be released and they'll start to grow. That's what we call apical dominance. So the apical meristem is the one that only gets to grow until it's missing, and then you get growth from the side through the axillary buds. So if you're someone who tries to grow basil at home, if you want to grow more basil, rather than plucking individual leaves off the basil and using them in your cooking and hoping that it grows more, it's actually better to cut off the whole top of the stem, leaving some leaves lower down, because then those axillary buds at the base of those lower down leaves will actually grow new shoots, and your basil will get bushier and you'll have more leaves to harvest later. All right, so that's all primary growth. That's the growth of the shoot up. But shoots also sometimes can grow out. This is what we call secondary growth. So this happens in woody plants like trees and shrubs that live for multiple years. So in addition to the cell division happening at the apical meristem in the tip, there's actually some other places within the stem where cell division can happen. And that's the structure where cell division, there's actually two structures in the stem where cell division can happen, the vascular cambium and the cork cambium. So when the initial growth happens, you have the growth of the apical meristem the cells elongate, and then they differentiate into different cell types. Some of those are going to be vascular tissue, so your xylem and your phloem. And there's a layer in some plants called the vascular cambium that is in the area of that xylem and phloem that can actually produce new xylem and phloem cells. So that vascular cambium can produce new cells. Cells on the inside of that vascular cambium are going to become xylem cells. Cells on the outside of that vascular cambium are going to become phloem cells. And so year after year, it can keep making new xylem and phloem, and that will gradually thicken the stem. And that's how you get wood. So the thing that we actually call wood is basically dead xylem cells. So that's what we use for construction and things like that. The other tissue in the stem that is producing new cells is the cork cambium. That's an outer layer on the outside of the stem, and that produces bark. So it can divide and produce that bark layer on the outside of a tree that protects that tree. So if you look at a cross section of a tree, you'll see these layers, the rings of wood, right? You guys have all probably seen wood rings. Those rings represent a year of growth of xylem. And the xylem is larger and grows more rapidly during the summer, and it's smaller and grows more slowly during the winter. So you get a dark line of dense wood where it's growing slowly, and then a line of lighter, less dense wood where it's growing rapidly. And so you can actually see the number of years that the tree has been alive by looking at those rings within the wood. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the root structure and how root growth happens. Root growth is pretty similar to stem growth in that you have one area at the tip of the root where cell division is taking place, and then you have a zone of elongation where the cells are getting larger, and then a zone of differentiation where they're differentiating into their different tissue types. Okay, so very much a similar structure to what you see in the stem. You also have at the very tip of the root what's called the root cap, and that protects that growing dividing section of the apical meristem of the root from any abrasion from the surrounding soil. All right, roots sometimes need to form branches as well, but it doesn't form in the same way that branches form on a shoot, because they don't have the buds, the axial buds that you see on a shoot. So the branching of roots actually comes from the endodermis, which is that layer of tissue around the central vascular tissue in the middle of the root. Remember we talked about the endodermis, we were talking about how water gets into the root. So the endodermis can actually have new apical meristems start to form from the edge of the endodermis, and they'll actually erupt out the side of the root and then cause a new root that's growing with its new own apical meristem. Okay? All right, so that's it for how plants grow, and I'll see you guys next time.